Welcome back to a new episode of Games I've Bought Recently, or Games I've Bought This Month. This month it is June 2010, we are already halfway, and I got some great deals this year and some awesome exclusive games, and there are a shitload of new games coming. I didn't get a huge amount of games, but I got some pretty expensive games, especially for the PSP. My buddy TB46667, or Tom, knows that because I already told him. So we'll just start off. First up is finally I got some new PlayStation 1 games. Not really, you know, high profile games, but whatever. First off, Crusader of Might and Magic. Battle Arena Toshinden 2. Tomb Raider The Last Discovery. Shadow Master. And Forsaken, and those two games are games I've played so much on a demo. And finally I got them. So that's some pretty awesome PS3 games, so not really awesome, but some PS3 games, so shut the fuck up. You know. First up is Stormrise. It was only 7 euros and I've heard it was really bad, but of course I like bad games, so just find out. And this is for my buddy Inor, or Einor. Yes, finally I got Dante's Inferno. Yes, yes, I know. Then a sealed copy of Gundam Target Insight. And this is actually pretty funny, or actually pretty rare, because it is a sealed copy and it's on a launch game for the PS3. And I like robots, so not planning of playing it though, because I heard it's really bad. Finally, again, got Dragon Age Origin, an incredible Western RPG. I totally love it. Terminator Salvation, pretty old game. Tomb Raider Underworld, Tomb Raider. Clive Barker's Jericho, because I hate games that are like bubbly and whatever. And Time Shift. So these are my PS3 games. I ordered some other games, but they didn't come out yet, so not very good. This is again for my buddy 2B46667. Because I know he loves his sealed games, and I went to the city today, and all of a sudden, like almost every normal game store, they had sealed copies of Kingdom Hearts 2, not Platinum. So of course I grabbed it because I got Kingdom Hearts 2 when it came Platinum, and I freaking hate that. And finally I got a sealed copy of Kingdom Hearts 2. Then State of Emergency, Gran Turismo 2002 Tokyo Geneva, R Racing or Rich Racing, whatever. A normal version of SX Tricky. A game I never heard about is Rebel Raiders Operation Nighthawk. It's like this flight simulation. I don't know if flight is just an arcadey fight game. Like a little bit like Ace Combat, but with big, massive war battles and warships, whatever. Second Sight, first was pretty good. Just for collection purposes, because I want to collect as much of PS2 exclusive Sony games, and it is The Getaway. Again, a game I've never heard about. Broken Sword, The Sleeping Dragon. Robotech Battlecry, I played this on the GameCube. Yes, on the GameCube, and I totally love this. Then, as you know, finally, King of Fighters Maximum Impact 2. Blood Omen 2. Zombie Attack. And if you can see it, you're like, think to yourself, this will probably be an you know, like a Western zombie game, but it's actually a Japanese game with Japanese characters, like a little bit of a hack and slash game. It's not very good, but whatever, you didn't know it. And last, Warriors of Might and Magic. So those are my PS2 games. And now onto the big stuff, onto the PSP. A lot of months in this year I didn't get a lot of PSP games, because for me there were like almost no good PSP games coming out, and finally they are coming. And now I wanted to wait for price drops on some of those games, but it didn't came, so I just got to grab them before they are like out of sale. First up is Phantasy Star Portable, and East the Ark of Nephilim is a really not a rare game, but this is like 50 euros still in Holland. So I've got this used for 25. Finally, I got Half-Minute Heroes. No, I didn't play it yet. I'm sorry. Because I was playing all freaking week Hexiforce. And I got this really expensive, because this is a game that is never Coming to the Holland of Coming to the EU. And it was 44 euros, freaking expensive. But this game is the best Japanese RPG I have played on the PSP. Well, maybe it's not better than Crisis Core, but Crisis Core is more like an action RPG. And this is really a standard RPG. So for everyone, I have seen the bad reviews and they are all freaking lying. Trust me on this, they are lying. This game is fantastic. Then, again, did you remember one of my videos? I told you that a colleague of mine, or just a buddy, gave me Soul Calibur Broken Destiny. And last week he gave me another PSP game, and it's Cyanide Resurrection. So always awesome if people give me games, of course. Saw this used Warrior Orochi. Steamboat Chronicles Battle Tournament, again a PSP, the game that will never come to you due to the AU, and I got it used. And I saw this, pretty weird, because it is SOCOM Fighting Bravo 3, and it was only 15 euros. And it's a game from 2010 that came out, well, I think, like 2 or 3 months ago. But as you all know, PSP games aren't selling in the AU or Europe, and so they drop in price really fast. Now, of course, a lot of people are asking me it, and I have to tell you, everyone that asks me this question, you should punch yourself because you are stupid. Of course, I'm going to get Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker for the PSP. So I hope this will be an awesome game. I heard this is like a great game on the PSP, and so that's it. So those were my games. For merchandise, I only got this statue from Mai of King of Fighters. It was only 7 euros, so of course I have to get it. No, I will not opening this, because I'm not a person that likes boxes, but I thought that this box is absolutely amazing. So, for the people that are interested in that, sometimes I do buy movies. I'm not really a movie freak, but I love Japanese movies and Asian movies. So, I've got Death Note 2. Three Kingdoms, looks awesome. I love Andy Lau. Yeah. An Empire, Empress and the Warriors. And the Chambara Bikini Warriors or something, I don't know. I think that an Xbox 360, there's a game from this movie. But I like quirky games. What? Now to the games I've completed. I'm doing these videos because I got a lot of questions and messages of people asking me which games do I complete, and do I complete a lot of games, and do I play them? Of course I play them, of course I want to complete them. This is my third video. I have completed 3 games in 2 months. This is the third month I've completed 4 games, and this is the month of the shooters, because I've completed Terminator Salvation. And again, people, please don't listen to all those paid review websites, because this game isn't that bad at all. And from Clive Barker's Jericho. This game isn't spectacularly good, it's just a normal game. I would rate it at a 7 or 7.5, or 7.5, I mean. And if you are scared of this game, you are a wussy. And I mean you. Yes, you know who you are. This game isn't as scared at all. Then, finally, I played SOCOM 3 and was totally, how do you say that? I wanted to play this game really, really fast, and I got really motivated, and I completed it in a day, and it's a great game. And because I completed SOCOM 3, I want to play the PSP versions, and again, even though the controls were a little bit stiffy in the beginning, I got totally used to it. And if anybody says to you that shooters on the PSP isn't possible, let them play this game, but because it is possible, and this game is amazing, and I'm trying to complete the second one, and of course I will play the third one. So these were the games I've bought recently this month, and of course see you next month.